So, a good day to everyone. I will be discussing on the chapter 2 on reproductive physiology of swine. So, last discussion, I've talked about the breeds of swine, the industry, as well as the different mating systems. So, now we're going to talk about the reproductive physiology. So, specifically on the reproductive organs. So we will talk about the reproductive organs of the sow and the boar. So next discussion we'll talk about the reproductive phenomenon. For now, it's all about the organs. So first is on the boar reproductive organs. So sa lalaki. So first is the testicles or testes. So when we say testicles or testes, these are paired organs suspended outside the body and enclosed in a sac called scrotum. So meaning yung nakikita mismo, yung nakikita ng naked eye natin doon sa parang yung testicle na tinatawag, hindi pa yun yung mismong testicle, nakapaloob pa doon yung testicle. Yung nakikita natin is yung scrotum. So yung ine-enclose ng scrotum, yun yung testicle. So, the testis at saka yung counterpart niya doon sa babae na ovary are similar in that they both contain yung gametes. So, for lalaki, it is the male gamete or the sperm. And then, sa babae, sa ovary, it contains yung female gamete or yung egg cell. So, the testes are can be a component of both yung reproductive system dahil dito nagproproduce siya ng sperm and the endocrine system since it can secrete hormone or it can produce hormone. So the testes produce sperm or the spermatogenesis na tinatawag yung production ng sperm as well as androgens, primarily testosterone. So kaya yung testes both an organ of the reproductive system as well as the organ of an of the endocrine system. So sa reproductive system, nagproproduce siya ng sperm. And sa endocrine system, nagproproduce siya ng testosterone. So yon. So for the testicle or testis, it is composed of the seminiferous tubule. So dito sa part na to, itong mga parang worms, parang itong mga nandito sa part na to. So, itong seminiferous tubule na tinatawag is composed of mga different sperms, mga cells. So, yung mga spermatogonia, spermatocyte, spermatid, and spermatozoa. So, ito yung mga nandito sa seminiferous tubule. As well as yung mga interstitial cells or yung Leydig cell na tinatawag, that produces yung testosterone at saka yung Sertoli cells or so-called the nurse cells. So, yan. That's for testicles or testes. Then, we go to the epididymis or epididymis. So, the epididymis is a very long convoluted tubule that connects the vasa efferentia of the testis with the vas deferens. So, dito naman sa part na to. Ito yung epididymis. Kinoconnect niya yung testis with the vas deferens. So, itong epididymis, it has three parts. You have the body of the epididymis dito sa part na to. And then, you have the tail of the epididymis. So, itong epididymis, it serves as a temporary storage area of sperm and is the site of sperm maturation. So, period of storage may last up to 40 days. So, yun. Diba dito sa part na to, dito sa testicle, yung seminiferous tubule, dun nang gagaling yung mga sperm cell. Then, hindi agad-agad pumupunta sa ibang part. So, nag-stay pa lang siya dito sa epididymis for maturation. Nagmamature pa yung sperm cell. So, it could, the sperm cell can stay here sa epididymis for as long as 40 days. So, that's the epididymis. Then, we have the ductus deferens or the vas deferens. So the vas deferens is also known as the ejaculatory duct because sperm will only pass through this duct during ejaculation. So yun, since nandito pa lang sa epididymis, dito nagmamature yung sperm cell. When it is time for ejaculation, yung bore, dadaan siya dito sa vas deferens. So yun, yun yung parang function niya. It serves as an ejaculatory duct. Because yung sperm cell will only pass through this duct during ejaculation. Then it forms part of the spermatic cord along with blood vessels and supplies and drains blood to and from the testes. So aside from as an ejaculatory duct, it can supply as well as drain blood to the testes and from the testes. So yun. That's for ductus deferens or vas deferens. Then we go to the urethra. So the urethra is a long tube extending from the urinary bladder to the penis that serves as a common passageway for both urine and semen. So dito dadaan yung semen at saka yung urine. So itong part na to from the urethra is held closed by the urethral sphincter. So yung urethral sphincter na tinatawag, it is a muscle, it is a muscular structure that helps keep urine in the bladder until urination can occur. So the male urethra can be divided into three sections: the prostatic urethra, the membranous urethra, and the spongy urethra. So yung prostatic urethra, it is the uppermost segment within the prostate. Then the membranous urethra, the segment within the urethral sphincter, kung saan makikita yung dito sa part na to, makikita yung muscle. And the spongy urethra, the lowermost and longest section within the penis dito sa part na to. So yung urethra kasi, it held close by, yun nga, yung muscle, yung urethral sphincter. And the male urethra is longer than the female and it passes along the length of the penis before emptying at yung sa gallbladder as at its emergence from the bladder. So, the urethra passes through the prostate gland and seminal ducts from the testes enter the urethra at each side, making it the pathway for transmission of semen as well as the discharge of urine. So, yun yung function ng urethra. Then, we also have the accessory organs. So, we have the seminal vesicle. So, itong part na to. These are paired glands that open in the urethra and secretes fluids that serve as a medium of transport for sperm cell. So, yun yung function niya. Di ba yung urethra, dun dadaan yung sperm cell. So, dadaan siya dito sa seminal vesicle. So, it will secrete a fluid. So, bakit to? So, may sinisecrete siyang fluid para parang doon yung medium or sasakyan ng sperm cell. So yun yung function niya. So these glands, itong seminal vesicle, are hollow. So hollow daw siya, then pear-shaped, mostly pear-shaped sacs in bore. So pwede rin pear-shaped sucks siya sa mga stallions, sa mga rams, sa mga bull, at saka sa boar. And sa mga ibang animals, they are lobulated. So parang na medyo parang mas rounded sila, lobulated lang sila, katulad doon sa aso. Pero for boar, it is pear-shaped sac. So it is the largest gland located in the pelvic system or the pelvic cavity. So yun, siya yung largest gland. Then we have here the prostate gland. So the prostate gland It is an unpaired gland located at the neck of the urinary bladder. So, medyo nandito sa part na to, sa neck ng urinary bladder. So, yung ginagawa nito, it secretes a thick alkaline secretion that gives the semen its characteristic smell. So, the fluid, yung sinisecrete ng prostate gland, it serves to regulate the vaginal acidity. So, yun yung ginagawa. Pinoprotect or nire-regulate niya yung acidity ng vagina. Kasi, parang yung thick alkaline secretion na sinisecrete niya, babalot dun sa semen. So, it serves as like a shield or it protects the semen from the acidity. Since it regulates yung vaginal acidity. So, ginagawa niya ito kasi for sperm cells, they are susceptible or parang ayaw nila sa acidic na environment. So, this will extend yung sperm cells lifespan and enables them to fertilize an egg for the longest possible period. So, yun yung function nung sinisecrete niyang alkaline secretion. Para ma-extend yung lifespan ng sperm cell at saka para mas efficient sila sa pag-fertilize ng egg. So, yung fluid kasi, it also includes mga proteins and enzymes para mag-help yung, para tulungan yung sperm cell na mag-develop and thrive on yung sa environment, dun sa vaginal environment. So, yun. That's for prostate gland. Then we have the Cowper's gland, itong part na to, or yung bulbourethral gland. So these are small paired glands located on either side of the urethra in the pelvic region. So the bulbourethral glands are tubo-alveolar glands that are around the size of a pea. So they are found in all domestic animals except in dog. So, nakikita mo dito, they are around the size of a pea. Pero dito sa Cowper's gland nung boar, medyo malaki. So, exception yung sa boar kasi yung Cowper's or bulbourethral gland nila are extremely large. Compared to the Cowper's gland of other animal. So that's for the Cowper's gland or bulbourethral gland. Then we also have the penis. So the penis is the organ of copulation. So organ of sex na tinatawag. So pag nagme-mate yung boar at saka yung sow. So it is divided into three general areas. You have yung glands, yung body ng penis, and then the free extremity. So, the cranial extremity of the boar penis is twisted. So, yun, nandito. So, pag nakakita na kayo yung nagme-mate na boar at saka sow, talagang makikita nyo na parang corkscrew yung penis ng boar. Talagang parang umiikot, twisted. So, yun yung penis. So, it is the organ of copulation. Then, we also have the mga muscles that are associated with the reproductive system of the boar. So, we have the cremaster muscle, which is a thin layer of striated muscles that surrounds the testis and the spermatic cord. So, yung ginagawa ng cremaster muscle, it will help pull the testis up against the inguinal canal. So, yung pagpupul niya ng testis up against the inguinal canal, it is an involuntary action which is known as the cremasteric reflex. So, yung function ng cremasteric reflex is to bring the testes closer to the warm environment of the body when they are exposed to the low outside temperature. So, yun. So, if you can observe, mas parang pumapasok. So, yung testes dun sa loob ng body ng animal when it is cold. So, when the outside temperature is cold. So, yun yung ginagawa ng cremaster muscle. So, parang involuntary niya na pinopull when the outside environment is cold, involuntary na pinopull yung testis or yung testicle inside the body kung saan mas mainit. So, yun. Then, we have urethral muscle. Helps in the transport of urine and semen in the urethra via the peristaltic action. So yun yung sa urethra naman. So yung muscle na to by peristaltic action gumagalaw yung urethra. Itong muscle na to yung gumagawa nun. So gumagalaw through peristaltic action, it will help transport yung urine at saka yung semen. Then, you have yung bulbous cavernous muscle, also called the bulbous spongiosus. So, it is a muscle of the perineum, the area between the anus and the genitals. So, yung ginagawa niya naman ay nagko-contract siya to expel the last drops of urine or semen. So, yun. So, pag sa urination, di ba, tuloy-tuloy, and then, meron sa dulo parang nagda-drop or nagdi-drip. So ito yung muscle kung saan tinutulungan niya yung baboy to expel yung last drop ng urine at saka yung semen. So yun yung kanyang ginagawa. And then we have the ischiocavernous muscle. So it is a paired striated muscle that covers the roots of the penis. So they contract and pull the penis dorsocranially against the bony pelvis. So when we say dorsocranially, so when we say dorso or cranially towards the head. So parang horizontal yung ano niya, yung parang position niya. So it will contract and pull the penis against the bony pelvis. So that's those are the muscles that are associated with the reproductive system. So yung mga ginagawa nila, they help yung mga other organs to do their functions. So yun yung mga muscles. Then we go to the sow reproductive organ. So first is the ovary. So ito, sinabi ko kanina, it is the counterpart of the testicle. So the ovary is a female reproductive organ that contains the ovum. So, the ovaries have both cytogenic and then endocrine function, just like the testicle. So, for endocrine function, may mga hormones rin siya na naproproduce at sinisecrete. And then, self-producing rin siya. So, the ovaries are almond-shaped in most species, including yung sow or yung swine. So, itong ovary na to nag-flow down siya into the fallopian tube into the uterus after being released where it can be fertilized by the sperm so itong ovary na to mga hormones nagsisecrete rin siya ng mga hormones that play a part in the menstrual or sa menstruation at saka sa fertility. So, that's for the ovary. Then, we also have the fallopian tube. So, when we say fallopian tube, it is are paired of convoluted tubules also known as the oviducts or uterine tube that serve as the site of fertilization. So, basically, pag sinabing fallopian tube, it is the site of fertilization. So, specifically, fertilization is said to occur at the ampullary ischemic junction in the oviduct. The most anterior portion is it is this part, ampullar ischemic junction in the oviduct. So ito, it is said that this is where fertilization occurs. Then the most anterior portion is expanded and is funnel shape, hence called the infundibulum, itong part na to. So, the whole of this is the fallopian tube. Then, these are the part. So, yung parang funnel shape dito, ito yung infundibulum. Then, we have the uterus. So, uterus, also called womb, an inverted pear-shaped muscular organ of the female reproductive system located between the bladder and the rectum. So, dito, sa part na to. Uterus. Then, you have the uterine horn. So, the uterus is the largest part of the female reproductive tract composed of two horns. Ito. And body. Itong uterine body or yung corpus. So, yung uterine body or yung corpus, it is most developed in mga monotocous animal. So, basically, it is largest in sa mga mare na animal, then less extensive or medyo hindi ganun kalaki in cow at saka yung sa baboy naman, it is small. So, yun. Then, we have the cervix. So, the cervix is considered the neck of the uterus composed of heavy, smooth sphincter muscles that are tightly closed except during estrus and parturition. So, yun. So, basically, itong cervix na to, ito yung parang gate dun sa uterus. So, sa mga pag nag-AI or pag nag-AI or nag-mate, mahihirapan o hindi talaga pwedeng makapasok yung sperm cell if hindi pa talaga in heat or hindi pa ready to mate yung sow. So, because itong cervix na to, tightly close siya throughout yung except for during estrus when the animal or the sow is in heat and parturition kung saan nag-o-open siya. So, doon lang mismo. Kung talagang hindi pa in heat yung animal, hindi pa talaga pwedeng makapasok yung sperm cell. Mahihirapan. Then, it connects the vagina, yung cervix, it will connect into the vagina with the main body of the uterus acting as a gateway between them. So, yun. Parang gate siya. So, yung cervix, it is distinct from the uterus. Kasi, naka-connect doon sa uterus. So, parang iisang organ na lang yung or structure na lang yung uterus at saka yung cervix. Pero it is distinct enough that it is considered as a separate anatomical structure. So, yun. Ito yung parang ano ng, ito yung vagina ng sow. Then, you have yung cervix. Dito nagsisimula. Ito. Ito yung cervix mismo. Then, dito yung parang daanan ng sperm cell. So, pag hindi pa in-heat yung animal, naka-close to. So, kahit anong mate mo, kahit anong AI mo, hindi talaga papasok pag hindi pa in-heat. So, that's for cervix. Then, we have the vagina. So, the vagina is called the birth canal and also the female copulatory organ. So, this is like similar to the penis, which is also yung vagina, it is called the copulatory organ. So, ito, part na to, itong vagina na to. So, the muscle walls of the vagina are thick and elastic in order to accommodate both the movement of the penis during intercourse and the passage of an offspring during delivery. So, yun. Thick at saka elastic daw yung walls, yung muscle wall nung vagina para ma-accommodate niya yung penis na papasok at saka yung passage ng offspring pag nanganganak. So, yung vagina, it will connect to the main body nung uterus. So, ito, nandito sa part na to, yung vagina. So, again, ito yung vagina, hindi ito. Yung nakikita natin, it is called the vulva. So, ito, the vulva guards the external opening of the female genital tract and it is composed of the labia majora and the labia minora. So it guards it from other parang mga dirt at saka mga iba pang harmful substances na pwedeng makapasok doon sa mismong reproductive tract ng animal, and it prevents it from infection, parang ganun. So the vulva is the main function. It enables urine to pass through. It acts as a mating opening, and it is part of the birth canal. So yun, ito yung mga functions niya, mga primary functions niya. Dito lahat na mag-exit yung urine. It is the mating opening. So dito ipapasok yung penis ng boar, and it dito rin lalabas yung offspring or yung anak ng sow. So that's the parang ng vulva function niya. So and that's for this discussion. So those are like the reproductive organs, mga main reproductive organs for boar and for sow. So for the next discussion, I will be talking about the reproductive phenomenon of the sow and boar. So when we say reproductive phenomenon, kung kailan mag-inhit, yung estrous cycle niya, yung paano sila nag-produce ng sperm, ng mga egg cell, ilan yung gestation period, mga ganun. So I will be talking more about that. So I hope you listen to my discussion and comprehensively. I hope you listen to it, and feel free to ask me any question. Just PM me regarding this video lecture. So thank you and have a good day.